In 22 years of marriage, Kevin and Wendy Pauls have changed. It's not just their hair and clothes, or even becoming the parents of three that have shaped them.
Halfway through this and there's not
one. It's time.
Marriage is a work of of endurance. And you have to do stuff every day to actually think about how you're going to make it better. You know, so whenever you think you've arrived, that's when you need it the most.
And that's why Kevin and Wendy took a dare last year, a 40-day exercise to give their relationship a tune-up. The love dare, featured in the movie Fireproof, is not the stuff of Hollywood. It's hard work. Even more challenging to document that dare and open up on national television.
We got a lot of comments from people. People were like amused and entertained, I think, by us, because we did try to be, you know, pretty real, open and honest. I think the funniest thing that happened was when we had people, I don't remember who it was, because I don't even think I knew who it was, that walked up to us in a grocery store and said, we're watching you. And I almost felt paranoid, like, oh my gosh. I thought, what if I'd just been like yelling at him in the grocery store or something? Like, people are watching us. So I started being careful for a bit, going, we got to be on our good behavior wherever we are.
The Pauls, along with two other couples, daily blogged and vlogged their way through the journey. The 40-day trip took them to places in their marriage, such as taking responsibility, resolving conflict, sharing dreams, and increasing the intimacy quotient.
Marriage is part of life's journey, and there's always, you know, twists and turns and detours, and so you just need to always be equipped and equipping yourself along the journey to do the best you can as you, you know, confront things.
For Kevin, a singer-songwriter, and Wendy, a life coach, the challenge wasn't to perform, but to be authentic. Their kids were among the many watching.
No, just kind of rolling their eyes every time we talk about marriage, or just like, oh, brother.
But don't you think they're watching you guys and learning from you guys?
For sure.
Very much so. I think they kind of roll their eyes, but they look at some other families that they go to school with, and they come home, and we've often heard them say, thank you for, you know, being here.
At 19 and 21, Wendy and Kevin were nearly children themselves when they got married. They say they didn't have a lot to prepare them for the road ahead, except their commitment to God and one another. 22 years after that walk down the aisle, they've acquired wisdom and experience. But they can't explain why their marriage has survived when so many don't.
I would love to say I know what it is, because it's the one question we get, or any couple that's been married for a while. How did you make it work? And I don't really know, because I see some of our friends that have, and I can't pinpoint it. What made them all of a sudden do the switch, and what happened? And I do think, I'm the youngest of eight kids, and watching my brothers and sisters go through their stuff, and watching their marriages, you know, some were great and some went through peaks and valleys and kind of all over the place. Being able to watch others and learn from that, and getting scared. I think it's good to get scared. You see people that you think have it totally going on, and the roof caves in, and you're like, how did that happen?
Domestic support.
Long before the love dare, the Pauls looked for ways to improve their relationship and reach out to other couples. They started a hot date night in their church and speak at marriage conferences. Still, they don't consider themselves experts, just a couple willing to learn and do the work.
You know, when close friends, their marriages begin to fail, and you look and you think, I don't know, you know, why they've had these challenges and that have turned out in this way. I mean, to some degree, I would be guessing, but I think some of it has to do with both parties having the willingness to work at it. I think another key thing is, and this is one of the things actually with our daughter that's 18, beginning to, you know, when you're speaking of future marriage partners, and she'll ask about qualities. She wants our input, which is fabulous, you know, in choosing a future spouse. And one of the things I've identified is somebody with a teachable spirit, somebody who is teachable, so willing to learn. And I think that both of us are willing to, you know, not always in the moment, like sometimes when somebody points something out, you can be defensive in the moment, but one of the
not
things
you.
I...
She's never like that.
You are so not authentic.
Humor was a big part of the Pauls' love dare journey and their relationship. It could also be what keeps them so strong. But all joking aside, did reading the book and doing the daily challenges make a difference in their marriage?
I was wondering that very thing at first, like thinking, what difference has it made? And I started asking Kevin, and he said something that as soon as he said it, I thought, yeah, that's what it is. And he said, you know, it's one piece of a bigger puzzle. And I thought, yeah, that's exactly what it is. So on its own, you know, did it transform our marriage or anything like that? I would say no, but definitely it played a part.
And when you put yourself out there as somebody who's trying to make your marriage work, it can be a little scary because people are now expecting you to
make it work.
Mm-hmm. And so there's some challenges that come with that. But that's, I mean, we've chosen to try to live our lives like that.
Welcome to day 26 of the Love Dare.
They admit they haven't cracked open the book since then, but they're taking what they've learned from 40 days and 22 years into the future.
I think in any area of life, you can't just, you know, learn something once and then expect to have a lasting impact from kind of one point of contact. Whether it's, you know, going to, you know, one church service, or whether it's, you know, reading one book on healthy eating, that one thing isn't going to make change last. I think it's one piece, and it's a good piece. It was a good thing. We enjoyed doing it, and I think it is a good tool for couples to use. When was the last time you looked at these?
Hairstyles and fashion change, and so does a marriage. For the Pauls, the dare isn't over, even if the blogging and bearing their souls to a nation is.
No. Don't ever think you've arrived. Don't ever think that this is as good as it's going to get. You can always get better, and you can always do more. And I just don't want to stop striving.
That is.
In Baden, Ontario, Denise Lottie, 100 Huntley Street.